Channeling is like setting myself aside and going into a deep trance until I disappear. Then there's nothing. In the old days, they used to say stepping outside of self, going into this empty state, this empty trance state, allowed somewhat a direct access to consciousness. Conscious channeling, the person is actually there. Yeah, and there may be influence from your own understanding. Trance channeling, there's nobody there. When I come back, I have no recollection of what went down, what was being said. It's a private session with you and consciousness. The channeler has no recollection, so as it's not gonna get in the way. A bit like as an interpreter at the United Nations, you can't afford to make up your own mind of whether you should what you should say. You simply say what is said. You repeat what is said in a different language. Randomly, I met a woman in Wellington in the early 1970s, and she taught us what she called meditation, which later on turned out to be channeling as we know it today. When I was first taught this by Margaret, she always used to say, you know, move towards the higher source rather than bringing it down towards you. So it was like, let's not stay on the physical but raise consciousness rather than bring consciousness down. I had an experience very early on where everything disappeared. And when I mean disappeared, everything disappeared. And I found that as I became more proficient at channeling, I arrived at that nothing state when nothing was there, and then the answers to questions seemed to be just an easy thing to communicate. But I didn't start actually channeling anything until much later, probably around about the 1980s, that I started doing that. And then one day, you know, we'd set up this channeling and Mercredan came through. The energetic of that was very, very different. And the way in which it interacted with the people in the room was very different. And from that moment on, that was the only one, the only thing that ever really came through. Mercredan doesn't exist. And that's the stunning thing. You know, we often have to have this idea that somehow consciousness has to be somebody. But consciousness is a shared reality. It's a shared state above it all. Mercredan really claims to be on the boundary between the endless consciousness and our awareness of events and things. So really, as Mercredan, I think that I'm just a translator, translating one language into another. Mercredan said, this is just a name, it's just an address. What it means is Master of Mercy. And that was all it is. It's just like your email address. I think I've been chosen to do this is because I have a natural ability to let go. I have a sort of natural trust in myself. So I was trained as a industrial chemist. I was an investigator, a researcher, and for me, if I was to ever say, what am I? I'm a researcher into consciousness. I think everyone comes in with some gift. I think that my gift just happens to be this. And it's taken years for us to get even close to a point where it's acceptable. So when I first started doing this, it was a challenge to keep aside my scientific mind and this channeling, which in a way kept me always skeptical about the whole thing. And I believe that was a useful, you know, that I didn't go off the planet with it. Like it kept some sort of sense with that. My teacher, this lady that I met, initially she used to say, there are some people are so spiritual that they're no earthly good to anybody. Early on, even back before 2000, Mercredan was talking about the coming changes, the coming shift. What he said, there was going to be a shift in consciousness, and a lot of other channelers were talking about this at the same time. But he always kept saying, "You're not ready. It's not happening. There's not enough of a shift yet to bring that about." And so he was constantly holding back. It's not yet. It's not yet. And then, I don't know, maybe 2016, 17, 18, there was a sudden shift, and he was saying, now it's beginning. And maybe we can all see how that's happened. When he talked about the shift in consciousness, he started to say there was actually a division of two universes, two worlds, where one would shift ahead like an evolutionary shift, and the other would stagnate, and eventually they would split apart and one of them would completely dissolve away. Again, at the same time, he was talking about the beginning of a new species of human. So not only is there a shift in consciousness, but there's an evolutionary shift in humanity. And so this is a marking point for human evolution. This new species is not radically different from us, except they have a different neurological setup, which allows them to have gifts and skills that we don't generally have. There is an environmental, social, and political, and commercial evolution in consciousness as well. It's all happening at the same time. We stand on the edge of a precipice. Everybody can see this is the case. The question is, how do we manage that as a species? And until we see that our job isn't to control everything, our job is to allow evolution to take its course, because it will. There's no way to fix anything. You know, and I think channeling is a natural evolutionary thing. Everyone is going to find themselves with more and more information coming at them, and they have to sort out whether it's true or not. How are you going to do that unless it speaks to you, not just like, oh, it's I feel good, like my heart, but it speaks to you as an obviousness. And that, in the end, is, if you like, the precursor to real deep channeling. I think one of the key messages is that the internal is reflection of the external. So we are in a in a relationship between what we see on the outside and what we see on the inside. So our beliefs are manifest outwardly, and they may be reflected back onto ourselves. So we create experience. All the external world is a reflection of our internal state of being. It's not just the external climate change. The internal climate is also changing, and that is what is known as the shift in consciousness. You know, do we want to continue storms? Do we want to continue with the age-old domination structure? Or do we want to have some calm? It's an internal conflict. Mercredan years ago said that we're coming into a shift in consciousness, and the three things that this will bring about is responsibility, accountability, and transparency. 10 years ago, he was saying, get prepared. And now he's saying, start acting. You know, like it's the long wait is over, and there is a period of time when, you know, when you decide which side, which of the universes you belong with. Do you belong with the progressive, or do you hope to hang on to the old? We're coming to a very different civilization than we've ever had before. And one of those things is we are learning that we are one group on a planet that we can no longer afford to annihilate each other. My hope is that we will come to, you know, that the differences are around the world, we will start to come together as a unit, as units of difference, and that we will learn respect and tolerance for each other, and to see that a difference is actually a gift. It's like an extra skill, you know. And for me, the biggest challenge of all is when we respect feminine as opposed to masculine, that there are two sides of the same coin. What I've said for a long time is there are two elements. There is economy and there is ecology. One is masculine, one is feminine. If we don't look after the ecology, then we are going to annihilate ourselves. You know, the economy, yes, you might have to look after that, but not at the expense of the ecology. And once we recognize these differences, then we will learn respect. So I hope that we can make a difference in the world, that we can provide some ways of looking at the alternatives, so that we as channelers, maybe not just myself but all of us, are working together to elevate a higher sense of awareness of each other. We ask the question, how do you do channeling? For me, it's really about putting myself aside, stepping out of the way, and dropping into a deep hypnotic state. Then I have my own ritual that I go through. I go through a little internal meditative ritual, dropping down into a place where I've let go of my identity. And at that point, there's a crossover, almost like I begin to pick up this energetic sense that Mercredan is there, that there is this quietness. And then, you know, then I sort of hand over, and Mercredan always comes across with a paragraph or, you know, a little few minutes of discussing something, setting the, I think he's setting the framework for the session, and then he will say, let's begin a conversation. And it's really conversational rather than question and answers. Always it is difficult for someone to understand that consciousness is not an identity. Consciousness is something available to everyone. But you cannot arrive at it hanging on to your old identity, to who you think you are, to how important you are. My dear friend has learned that. My dear friend truly has no real importance with himself. So he can drop the identity, become one, shall we say, to merge at the edge, so that, shall we say, he can hear the vibrations from within the source. Much, shall we say, like the source of a river begins, shall we say, with just a trickle, but it has a sound. So he can hear and translate that into, shall we say, usable ideas. It is not a person as such. Neither he nor I are persons. We have said that the shift in consciousness has begun, and shall we say that such a change is not, shall we say, slow progression, but almost as if it is an instant change in attitude. We have talked about the climate, the external climate, of course, and the internal climate. And in this present moment, shall we talk as the meeting of the two? Because you are at the precipice of a shift in attitude. If that does not occur, then I will say it will occur without your input. Shall we say the planetary guardian is losing patience with how human beings think that they can control it all. And so, shall we say, the shift in consciousness has begun, and whether you like it or not, humans will necessarily need to come together. There are always more and more challenges if that does not occur. So war does not bring it about. The shift in ecology and the climate does not bring it about. The loss of species has not brought it about. But when you are all under attack from the same source, then you will recognize that you are all in it together. Shall we say, always, at all times, it has been waking up the idea of aware of your footprint, that is, wherever you stand, whatever attitude you take on, always has consequences. One would need to consider what your consequences, what impact your consequences have on other people. That is mostly important, because whatever occurs eventually will find its way back home. So many people think that they can get away with, shall we call it, a crime, but the crime always returns in different ways. One always has to live with self. Even if you deny yourself that you are living with yourself, it will affect how you are in the world. Once again, thank you for your time and your willingness and your import, because it is, shall we say, a multi-dimensional project, because we are all working to project it into the world. Thank you and good afternoon.